Hello there, today I'll be starting a Devil May Cry 5 gameplay. It will be dual commentary with Henry.
Hello everyone. Hi, hello.
I'm running this on PC, on Mac graphics, but with no anti-aliasing, and I'm using an Xbox 360 controller. Let's get started.
Xbox 360 controller there, Stu,
right? Yeah. I've been playing this for a little while now, 8.5 hours, and I'm still only on Mission 16, which is about halfway through. It's a very good game, seriously.
I play on console, and yeah, I don't get the experience on PC with the better graphics.
But yeah. I won't be playing on Nephilim, simply because it will be really frustrating and unentertaining to watch, because it will be repeating the same thing over and over. But I'm not going to play on Human, because that's way too easy. That's one thing.
You just could play Devil Hunter.
Yeah.
Demon Hunter.
Yeah, whatever it is. One thing I have noticed is that this game is really easy on easy, really easy on hard, medium, and then slightly difficult on hard, where it should be hard on easy, harder on medium, and really hard on hard.
You got to go to Son of Sparta.
Yeah. Maybe when I finish it on Nephilim, it'll unlock a harder difficulty. This is the intro cutscene.
In the intro.
Yep.
Yes, by close of trading Friday. No, you can't have more time. You know the terms, you know the consequences. No, this is not a veiled threat. This is a direct one. Should you fail to comply, the collapse of the economy will be on your head. I will make sure that you are stripped of power, shamed, and hated. Mm. Is that clear enough for you? Well, Friday it is then. You have a good night, Mr. President.
Shock horror, Mr. President.
So, did you get it, my darling?
Over a trillion.
Oh.
Soon I will own everything worth owning. I will control the world through debt. I have absolute power.
The world is at last your bitch, as am I. Nothing left but to grab it by the hair, bend it over, and what's the matter? What's the matter?
A loose end.
A loose end? What?
The son of the traitor Sparta, Dante.
Him.
He's still out there.
The hunters will find him. They found Sparta and his whore. And when they do,
I will rip open his chest with my bare hands and feast on his beating heart.
NSFW, by the way.
NSFW?
No, not safe for work.
Can't stay away, burning alive. I cannot breathe this poison air filled with lies. I cannot see what's done to me. Living free, the sun is falling from the sky.
Nothing left to express my life is in. Now found some pieces, million reasons. Why should I keep myself away? Hard to define. It always says it's hard to scream with your throat full of glass. I cannot help it, can't decline. It's always better down the line. I'm in the wrong, and I've done it all before. And I wish I'd never been. And I know it's just a dream. Now I'm blind, I can't open my eyes. Can't stay awake, burning alive. I cannot breathe this poison air filled with lies. I cannot see what's done to me. Living free, the sun is falling from the sky. Can't stay.
The demons have been increasing their power for millennia. They're on the verge of controlling mankind. Citizens, we've been kept asleep in a manufactured illusion for too long. We must wake up.
The masked lunatic you saw there claims to represent an organization called the Order. Now, this group has claimed responsibility for several serious attacks in recent weeks. He is undoubtedly a traitor and a terrorist. And I, for one, am not for the death penalty. One way to do it. Illegally shoot the son of a bitch.
This is Bob Barbas, just doing God's work.
Dante! Get out of there! You're in danger!
Always love that.
Who are you? What do you want?
You were careless. You left a trail. Now he's on to you.
What are you talking about? Who's on to me?
The Hunter Demon. He's here.
He's dragging you into limbo.
Demon's dumb.
It's too late. You're gonna have to fight your way out.
Day for a hangover. No more.
Get your filthy fucking claw off my trailer. Missed.
Such a good cutscene intro. That's so good.
Probably one of the best ones I've seen for a while.
Definitely.
So, how are you going to be your playstyle to start off with?
Sorry, what was that?
Your playstyle to start off with, are you going to be Rude Boy, Massive, smashing the shit out of stuff, or are you going to play...
Air combo, my favourite black playstyle.
Fair enough.
If you so guys... The controls are pretty simple. Y is attack, B is launch, R is R button is dodge. Pretty standard.
Say, if you guys don't really understand what Devil May Cry is, it's basically about a guy called Dante.
Who is this
who
guy?
Who is the son of Sparda, and the son of...
Dante!
What's her name?
Who said that?
Eva, I think.
Or something like that. Anyway, basically, it takes place in, like, it's modern day cities, I think. What city is it? I can't remember. Did they actually tell you what city it is?
No, but it should be. It's probably in the north somewhere, the princess.
It looks like London, but. Sometimes it looks like London, but. Or Italy or something.
One of the art designers is British or something, one of the companies that works for is British. And you see another allusion to that soon. But yeah, I mean, it might be based slightly on some of the big buildings in London, and then most of it based in the other country, wherever it's from,
Ebony,
New York or whatever.
Harry, Mr. Goods.
Yeah. So anyway, yeah, it's in limbo basically. So if you've seen Inception or anything like that, it's kind of like a parallel universe,
parallel plane
type thing, basically, isn't it?
Yeah, in one of the mythologies, either Roman or Greek, something like that. I need to set subtitles on it. Do that quickly.
Read about this, guys.
Yeah, sorry.
And he's got a brother called Virgil.
But you don't know that yet.
Yeah, well, it doesn't really matter. It's not a spoiler, is it really?
No, it's not.
Yeah, he's got a brother basically. It's more of like a twin.
But it is his twin. They're twins. Well,
yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, he's a pretty awesome guy. It was released on Feb 5th.
Of this year. As you saw from
the cutscene start bit, it's made by Capcom. And let's have a quick look. Apparently it's meant to ship 1.2 million copies. As of January 2013, 1 million copies had been shipped. Oh. Been getting like 9s out of 10s, 8 out of 10s, 4.5 stars, 5 stars, 80 out of 100. It's not a bad game. It's on all platforms.
Well, major platforms.
Well, apart from Mac.
And Wii. Isn't it?
Well, it'd be quite funny on Wii, wouldn't it? You'd be like running around the room, slashing things up. Yeah, it's good. It's an enjoyable game. So, what are we up to now? What beat you on?
I can see you clearly.
About to shoot Cat in the face.
A psychic. I can phase into Limbo and communicate with you.
That's not a spoiler, it doesn't happen.
Talk to you, but I'm not actually in Limbo with you.
If you don't know who Kat is, she is the hot chick that basically can see into Limbo.
Yeah.
I want to help.
Now, the plot of this game is pretty simple. You're a guy, you've lost your memory, but you're not human.
I know how to get out.
And you keep going into Limbo constantly.
Don't want to fight the hunter.
And you fight some people. And then you find there are stats as people play through. The gameplay in this game is it gets fiddly later on, but it's still fun, enjoyable, not very frustrating most of the time. It is a little bit on hardest difficulty, but that's fun. And yeah, I think it's really good. What do you think about it, Henry?
Well, on Xbox, it's pretty enjoyable playing it. Like, even though you're playing at how many, like, probably like 60, 70 frames right now, or you get your choppy.
Oh no, because recording it's 30. I set it to 30 so that it's less choppy. But well, I get 120 when I normally run
it. Yeah, so when you're playing, on thingy, it's pretty good for you. Where on Xbox, I basically have to get my straight 30, 35. It's still quite good. It doesn't. I don't know really. What's it like playing with keyboard and mouse?
It is abysmal. Do not even try that. Seriously.
Difficult.
I mean, space is jump, and you use jump more than you use anything else later game. And things like control Q and E control other things. Like you'll see when later on you get different weapons. Use those other weapons. The buttons are a bit awkward. Keyboard. Unless you have like a crazy typing hand, you'll probably find it really awkward.
So if you're gonna buy a PC, make sure you buy it and have a controller on hand. You may enjoy using the keyboard and mouse, but
it'd be more of a challenge. Difficult. Yeah.
But it is a game that challenges you. It's not one of these new games that's come out, same as all the others, too easy, 4-year-old could pick it up. It's actually a game that is, well, hack and slashes are hard games.
Yeah, but even the really hard ones, like the new Metal Gear game, it's either you're really good at it because you know how to block and you can be bothered to pause and defend, or you play it and you just run through it pressing whatever the button is. Constantly. I don't like that game, to be honest. It feels like a knockoff of these, but in the Metal Gear universe. It's barely even in the Metal Gear universe. But anyway. Yeah, definitely a good game. I'm just going to find some good abilities. I can get enemy step. I've never used that. I think I'll upgrade to roulette, so in the air I can do that. It lifts me up higher, basically. It's really useful.
I'd also say that it's probably the better one. This is where you get all the haters, but I would say it's almost one of the better ones in the series compared to the older ones.
I think if Devil May Cry 1 had... oh, it's cutscene, by the way. There's a British flag in this code. That's one of the allusions to British.
We go live to our eye in the sky. Steve, I can't believe what I'm seeing.
An allusion to one of the fact that it was British helped, and then it was partially made in Britain. Anyway, back to fighting. Did a nice call to Paris.
Oh yeah, it's I'd recommend it. Stu would recommend it.
I would say it's one of the best years games this year so far, which is like 1 of 3. So yeah, it's a very good game anyway. If it came out in 2013, it probably would have got my Game of the Year if I had an official award for Game of the Year, which I don't.
It did come out in 2013. Do you mean
2012? Sorry, yes, I did mean 2012. God, I think it's 2014 already.
I'd still say that I probably would go down the line of checking up some of the older lore, maybe, if you wanted to, so you can get kind of a grip of what's going on. It isn't really the same. They've kind of twisted some of it, but yeah. It's still
same
nice
characters.
To have a look back. Have a look back and see what the old games used to be like, because this new one, quite a big difference.
Yeah. I would actually say, as I was about to say before the cutscene, Devil May Cry 1 was very hard to play because I was like, I don't know, not even born yet or something when it came out. But Devil May Cry 2 was not a good game.
I completed it in the womb.
Yeah.
Completed it in the womb.
Ow. That wasn't a very good game, it was too easy, really easy I think it was. Devil May Cry 3, however, oh, I played that. That was fantastic. Okay, so these are locked doors, you have to find keys to open them. I don't know where the key is.
He doesn't like doing that. I've collected almost all of them.
I find it annoying because it keeps your score down. I would be getting triple S's on my other character, but I'm getting
it's one of those things that makes you go back and play it again. Play it more.
I didn't even
go. That's why it's there.
I don't collect the stuff when I play it again. I mean, I've played 8.5 hours and I haven't even finished the missions yet. Just because I like playing it, I don't like collecting stuff.
That's fair enough, but I would recommend you, when you finish, go back and look for the collectibles.
Yeah, I want to do all the secret missions.
If you can be bothered, though, that is.
Oh, there's something else I can't open. Oh, there's a soul here. Now, the music in this game, as you probably noticed in the first cutscene. Something over here.
Something's happened. Something's happened. Dude's doing something.
Out. There's another room over here, didn't you notice? No, there's the music in this game, as you would have seen in the club earlier in the cutscene at the start, it is fantastic. That's like one of the songs, and then the rest, half of it's made by Noisia, half of it's made by a band called Combo Christ.
Yeah, that's it, Combo Christ.
Combo Christ. Yeah. If anything sounds techy, techno type, it's probably Noisia. And if it sounds metally, or new metally, or whatever,
not good.
That's Combo Christ.
Yeah, whatever.
See, it's not that really. It's, I don't know really. It's quite a good way out, like weighing. Would you call it? It's on. If you put it on a scale, they scale together quite well. It levels the game nicely.
Yeah.
Like, way too much noise, you would probably make the game a bit like, it's too much of this. It's always constant,
yeah,
like drum and bass dubstep, and then the Chroma Christ comes in, and you're like, oh, this is quite nice. And a bit of crazy shit going on.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. But they're both really good bands. I mean, if you haven't checked them out, you should definitely check out Noisia. Combi Christ, I think it suits better in the game than outside the game.
Yeah, I tried listening to it outside the game, and I don't know, really, it didn't hit off with me, really. And I was listening to Noisia way before I was played Devil May Cry anyway. So.
Yeah, I listened to Noisia way before it was cool.
Before it was cool.
I joke, I only started listening to Noisia about 6 months, 8 years, 8 months ago, something like that.
8 years? Jesus.
Visuals in this game.
Bloody sick. Is that a good one?
Yeah, the graphics aren't too brilliant, but the visuals are fantastic, whether you pay attention to the graphics or not.
Oh no, but it's not the graphics that bothers me. I don't care about graphics anymore in games.
No, yeah, of course. I agree with you completely there, but it is nice to play a really pretty game.
Oh yeah, I'm not denying that, but you have good graphics, and then you have good, amazing graphics, and then a shit game. Not calling anyone out. Crisis.
Yeah, that game is unbelievably boring to play single player.
Multiplayer, not actually too bad. Played the beta, liked it. probably won't buy it though. I was debating buying it or not when it was coming out.
But like, you've got it on you'll have it on Xbox because you can't run it on your laptop. And to be honest, it won't be that pretty on Xbox. The plants definitely won't be as nice, and that's basically what they made really pretty.
And but you said the water's not amazing, but I think it's all right. You can fight it now. I'd give it like if you gave it a rating, the game of Crysis, I'd be like it's probably I don't know.
So am I.
7 out of 10, maybe 6 out of 10, but overall. And then for the whole game, like it's yeah, 6 out of 10 for the whole game. Graphics, 9 out of 10. Gameplay, single player, 4 out of 10. Multiplayer, probably 6 out of 10. 7, 8 out of 10 if you're playing with friends.
Yeah, you'll see that this is one of the probably the easiest, second easiest boss fight I'd say so far in the game.
Are you gonna triple S it?
I probably won't because I don't have all the attacks on them to use on it. Like, I flawless this on the hardest difficulty, that's what I mean by the game not being hard.
Yeah, but you, like I said, you went back and you had all the good shit.
Yeah, but I've only played half of this, I haven't got all the good shit, I've got some good shit. I think I have all the weapons, but I don't know that because I don't know what's up.
I don't want to spoil it for you, because that would be ridiculous.
My opinion of this game is, I give it a 9 out of 10. I don't give many games 9 out of 10s. I don't really like many games. I played it loads though.
I give it an 8.5, 8 out of 10. There's a few things about it that you could probably change. But I don't want to get too picky with it. If you know
definitely
what I mean.
The story so far is better than the old one. The old one was cliched and all that. This one's added something.
The story's one of the best stories I've played. Like, okay, you can't compete with these games now that are almost feature movies that have been instead of games. I don't want to say this, but Call of Duty stories are pretty good. The new Black Ops 2 story was wrote by a director.
Yeah.
And, well, I think it was.
Oh,
so
got statistic, okay.
That's something you can't compete with, but taking a lore from the games that are, how old are they, the older ones?
Very old.
Bloody old, bloody old, that's a good one. They were just, it's a good game, and it deserves its praise.
About to kill this thing. There we go. Start to slay it with a vertical downstrike. Okay, it's a cutscene now.
Game over.
Son of
Sparta.
Son of who?
You have been found. You are dead. Just like your mother. Poor mother. I don't know my mother, but if you're calling me a son of a bitch, you wouldn't be the first.
Oh, that's funny.
I love his cockiness. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's so good.
My mother. I barely remember her.
Are you okay, Dante?
How do you know my name?
My boss knows you. He wants to meet. Please? I helped you back there.
I didn't ask for your help.
Called The Order. Heard of it?
Something to do with that masked freak on the net?
That's my boss.
Wonderful. Can't wait.
We're just receiving reports of a terrorist attack that's taken place at the Bellevue Pier in the Western District of the city. Police are asking the public to remain vigilant
further terrorist attacks could take place anywhere, anytime, and when you least expect them.
We have your scent, son of Sparta. Now it is just a matter of time.
So we're back in the room, and I have a few things to say.
A few things.
This game is fantastic. I highly recommend it, and I can't wait to play through the rest of it. So yeah, just gonna let my score run out. I've got 2 upgrades, nearly 3. So I got an S. Was hoping for a double S maybe, but I don't think you can get that with completion. So that's why I get annoyed. I don't like how you have to get completion to get a good score, but I mean, it makes sense, kind of. So yeah, that's where we're gonna end it.
Hope you enjoyed.
Yep. See you next time. Cheers. Bye.